Good morning, students. Class 10, welcome. Today, let us learn Chapter 1, Periodic Properties and Variations of Properties. I have already taught you the first three properties. Today, I will take you further to one more property, that is ionization potential. Now, look at this, you know, in the gist I have given you, you know, all the six properties and their variation down the group and across the period. Just look at this here. Atomic size down the group increases, across period decreases. Metallic character increases down the group and decreases across the period. Non-metallic character decreases down a group and across the period increases. Now today, we'll learn the fourth one, is that is ionization potential. What happens to the variation down the group? It decreases and across the period increases. So, first, let us talk about ionization energy, the definition of ionization energy. What is the definition? The amount of energy required to remove the most loosely held electron from an isolated gaseous atom in its ground state and form a cation. Cation, what is the meaning of cation? Cation means positively charged ion. Okay, a neutral atom, by losing electron, it forms a cation. And to form a cation, certain amount of energy is required. That energy is what is known as ionization energy. The unit is kilojoule per mole or electron volt. What is the relationship between electron volt and kilojoule? 1 electron volt per atom is equal to 96.5 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so that's the thing. And of course, there are successive ionization energies. Are the first ionization energy, that is known as I1, and here it is the removal of 1 electron from the ground state. And second ionization energy, that is I2, removal of 1 electron from the monopositive. Monopositive, see, it has already become a cation. That is, let's say, Na plus. Now, Na plus, by losing 1 electron, it will become Na2 plus. But Na2 plus doesn't exist. It normally takes place for the electrons which are more. So, then finally, it becomes I3. That means that monopositive ion again loses 1 electron. It becomes a divalent ion. Okay, so this is what is known as the first and second and third ionization energy. Among all these things, you note one thing: it is easier to remove electron from a neutral atom than from a positively charged ion. So then the first ionization energy is easier. Okay, so variation of ionization potential down a group. I already told you it decreases. What is the reason? The reason is the nuclear charge increases down the group. And atomic size increases. Now, when you compare both, the atomic size, the effect of atomic size outweighs the effect of nuclear charge. Outweighs the effect of a nuclear charge. So, let's take an example here. Look at this periodic table. Just show the periodic table here. Now, this periodic table, if you notice here. Now, this is down the group. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. Is it down the group? Down the group, the number of shells increases. When the number of shells increases, automatically the atomic size increases. When the atomic size increases, the distance between the center of the nucleus and the outermost shell increases. Alright, increases. So, automatically losing electron will be easier. So, there is no need much energy. So, ionization potential thus decreases down the group. And across the period, ionization potential increases. What is the reason? The reason is the nuclear charge increases by one unit. The added electron enter into the same shell. Electrons do not shield each other, so the atomic size decreases. Atomic size decreases. As a result, what happened? Ionization potential across the period increases. That means when the atomic size decreases, ionization potential increases. That means there is a tremendous amount of energy required to remove the electron. Okay? There is a lot of strong pull between the nucleus and the electron. So, as a result, it needs a tremendous amount of energy. Therefore, ionization potential increases across the period. So, this is enough for today. Rest of the things we shall see, learn later. Thank you very much. Bye.